Inner Traditions Audio presents Spirit Weaver, Wisdom Teachings from the Feminine Path of Magic by Seren Bertrand, read by Aura Paige. Introduction. Welcome inside the Great Weave. Awin Aganav, Oduvin Is Digaf. I sing, Awin. I bring it forth from the deep. Bardic Invocation. Ours is only a little power, seems like, next to theirs, Moss said. But it goes down deep. It's all roots. It's like an old blackberry thicket. And a wizard's power, like a fir tree maybe, great and tall and grand, but it'll blow right down in a storm. Nothing kills a blackberry bramble. Ursula K. Le Guin, Tehanu. Welcome, dear listener. I am happy to share this audiobook with you, and I hope it lands in your life like a blessing. Imagine that this collection of essays is a weaving river. Dip in where you feel called, and soak up a little bit of simple feminine magic. We need this magic now more than ever. We've been doing the work, but we also need to be the beauty. Feminine magic is a homecoming to our true nature. These essays are not here to teach you or to tell you, but to sprinkle a little fairy dust over you. Keep this audiobook accessible on your device to listen to when you need a little lift. This is your witch's treasury, which brings an everyday grace to your life. No big effort needed. We need this simplicity and sense of grace and blessing. Remember, you are always blessed. Spirit keeping is about a deep connection with the land, the story of the land, and the stories kept within our body, and the weave between people and the land which keeps on being rewoven. Everything I've learned is from the memory and the stories told by the land, and the stories of my body that can have a cup of tea and a chat with the slow earth vibration that hums and exists right underneath our busy modern world. The other world is not just another time that's long gone in the past, but another dimension existing right now when we slow down and reconnect. So these stories and love notes are humming with all the places I've visited and the stories I've journeyed through during the 7 years I wrote them, including the memories of those spirit keepers who've now passed into Rainbow Land and those who are still holding the thread. These stories were mostly woven together between 2012 and 2018, when I was holding space for a global feminine mystery school and weaving with a circle of womb oracles whose wisdom brought up new questions and ideas to take to the land so Earth could share what she knew. Looking back now, we can see that between 2012 and 2019, the world was in an in-between space, a time out of time, in betwixt the worlds, as prophecies had predicted. In the spirit weave of lore, an old world died on the winter's eve of 2012, and the new world didn't take shape or form until 2020, catapulting us into a massive disillusion as the new birth started in earnest. Mayan astrology predicted that the initial gateway to a new cycle would open on winter solstice 2012, but that the real bolt through the gate would happen on winter solstice 2019. In those liminal 7 years in between, the veils were very thin, and the ancestors were speaking, and I, boarded on a womb ship sailing from one old world to a new land, was listening carefully. These essays are infused with that listening, so the ancestors' words can keep speaking to us now. Awin, Avalon, Swan Ladies. This ancestral voice, calling me into a deeper relationship with spirit weaving, began as we were about to enter 2012. I wasn't in my homelands of England at the time, and was involved in a situation that was very difficult. One day, I was praying for guidance to the divine. Instead, my prayers were answered by someone entirely different. The old mermaids of Albion. In a spirit vision, I was taken across a wild gray sea that was so familiar to me it felt the same as the blood flowing through my veins. It was the North Sea, on the north coast of England in Yorkshire, where I was born. Mermaids were swirling on the winds, and in the frothy tips of the thrashing waves, and escorting me into a cave. Inside the sea cave, the mermaids infused me with a sea spray of wisdom from their ancient folk, giving me an energy transmission. It felt as if a salty flood from those wild, magical, ferocious seas had passed right through into my DNA. Afterward, there was a knowing in me that I couldn't explain, but felt like a homecoming. Later on, with some research, I discovered there were numerous legends of mermaids in the caves at Flamborough Head, where I had been taken in my spirit vision, and that local folklore says that at nearby Runswick Bay, also by the North Sea, women would carry their children into a cave at night for cures, believing that a powerful spirit inhabited the womb-like cave. So the ancestors were calling me back home, not just in a physical sense, but in a deeper sense, calling me back into the stories in my body, in my bones, in my blood, in my womb, and in my lineage. I also reconnected to the magical cloud end in the northwest of England, a place where the veils were thin and that was once sacred to the witches and wizards of the old ways of magic. In the dream time, the word Awen was imprinting on my consciousness, and so I began my apprenticeship into the path of Awen. This involved many adventures, including a rebirth ceremony in a coit, a megalithic stone chamber that consists of standing stones capped by a large stone, on the Welsh borderlands with a wily witch lady, a communion with the sacred lands of Savioc in Cornwall, home to a sacred healing spring and the legacy of the swan priestesses dedicated to the goddess Bride or Brigid, and a deepening of my relationship with the sacred lands of Avalon in Glastonbury, home of the Lady of the Lake, and the holy island of Iona in the Hebrides in Scotland. Known as the Isle of Druids and once home to a famous witch oracle, like the Oracle of Delphi, whom kings visited to take counsel and prophecy from. Over time, life and the land were weaving my spirit back into wholeness, and I was remembering something long forgotten and fragile as an early morning glittering in a spider's web, unseen but now illuminated by a rising sun, so that I could see the threads, the web nodes, the weave. The ancestors were asking me to become an Awaneth, a Brythonic word for a native British spirit keeper of the lands. The tradition of Awen is one of inspiration, spirit, receiving energy, and weaving it back into the world. Awen is the flowing feminine energy spirit that infuses all the living creation, both seen and unseen. It's the juice of creation, most abundant in a woman's womb, that creates life. It is Shakti, anima, magic, enchantment, kundalini, and the Holy Spirit. An Awaneth, a spirit keeper, is a weaver of stories from the feminine energy magic, from Mother Earth, and a chalice that channels the rays of wisdom flowing from the cosmic womb. Mamtor, home of the ancestors. Sitting at the heart of these essays I share with you is the story of my personal ancestral lineage at Mamtor, Mother Mountain. In the Peak District of the Old North of England, once the Grail lands of Maid Marian and Robin Hood and the ancient tribe of the Brigantes, who worshipped the goddess Brigantia, the ancient mother of the Old North, who were once led by powerful queens. These lands are an ancestral soulmate within me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.